Thank you so very much, Madam Chairwoman. Congressman Berman and ER members of this committee, thank you so very much for having this hearing here today on a very important and very difficult topic. And for the opportunity to brief this committee on the implementation of the ongoing U.S. strategy to help our regional partners mitigate, eliminate the threat posed by the Lord's Resistance Army. We are deeply grateful for Congress's widespread bipartisan support for the LRA Disarmament and Northern Uganda Recovery Act that was signed last year. The legislation sent a very strong message, not only the support of Congress, but of the American people, that we will help to protect civilians and bring an end to the LRA threat. We also want to express our deep appreciation to the hundreds of thousands of Americans who have stood and mobilized and expressed their concern for the communities under siege by the LRA, and also the people who are here today and those who are who have the courage to stand up to the atrocities of the LRA. For two decades, the LRA has terrorized innocent people across Central Africa. The LRA has filled its ranks with abducting tens of thousands of children and forcing them to become child soldiers and sex slaves. From 2005 to 2006, the LRA moved from Uganda into the more remote border regions of Central African Republic, the Democratic Republic of the Congo, and what is now known as the Republic of Southern Sudan. In that region, the LRA has continued to commit atrocities. The United Nations estimates that over 385,000 people are currently displaced in this region as a result of the LRA activities. And according to the UN, there have been over 250 attacks attributed to the LRA this year alone. Over the recent years, regional militaries have worked together to pursue the LRA across a vast area of densely forested and difficult jungle terrain. They have had some success in reducing the LRA's numbers and keeping them from regrouping. However, as long as the LRA's leader, Joseph Kony, and other top commanders remain at large, the LRA will continue to pose a serious regional threat which undermines stability and development. As reported to Congress in November 2010, our strategy centers on four areas: the increased protection of civilians, apprehension and removal of Joseph Kony and the senior LRA commanders from the battlefield, the promotion of defections from the LRA in support of disarmament, demobilization, and reintegration of remaining LRA fighters, and finally, the provision of continued humanitarian relief to afflicted areas. Over the past year, the United States has continued to work with the United Nations, the African Union, and the regional governments to sustain and increase diplomatic and military pressure on the LRA. We have provided logistical support, training to the regional militaries pursuing the LRA. The United States has a strong interest in supporting our partners in the region to develop their capacity and to address the threats to peace and security posed by the LRA. The United States is now deploying U.S. military advisors to improve our support to the regional coalition to increase the likelihood of successful military operations against the LRA, and I would defer to my colleague, Ambassador Birchbaum, in the Department of Defense to describe the details of those operations. We continue to consult with all the regional leaders, and they have all said granted their consent for the deployment of these advisors to the field. Remember, this is a short-term deployment with specific goals and objectives. We believe the U.S. advisors can provide critical capabilities to help regional forces succeed. We will regularly review and assess whether the advisors' effort is sufficiently to enhance the regional effort to justify continued deployment. Our ambassadors and embassy staff will work closely with these advisors and make sure that they're sensitive to civilian protection consideration and local regional political dynamics. The State Department has also deployed an officer to the region to help coordinate all of our efforts in the field to counter the LRA and the work with these advisors. The administration is funding projects to help communities in the DRC develop protection plans and join an early warning network. This includes setting up high-frequency radios and cell phone towers. The same kind of early warning and basic telecommunication capacity does not yet exist across the border in the CAR. We recognize this gap, and we hope to work with our partners over the coming year to help address this. We will continue to work on the LRA fighters to peacefully disarm and leave the organization ranks and to come home. And currently, there are about 12,000 who have done so. Over the coming months, we will continue to work with the regional governments to ensure that the rank and file fighters and abductees who escaped the LRA have the necessary support to be reunited with their families and reintegrated into normal society. So, Madam Chairwoman, again, we appreciate and we are grateful to you and the members of both the House and the Senate for this bipartisan support in countering the LRA. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.